Hey, what's up guys? My name is Frozen Fractal, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create a YouTube logo completely for free. If you want to get started on YouTube, buying a paid software might seem enticing. However, you really don't need to spend any money to create a stunning looking logo. Today I will be using Pixlr, a completely free online image editor which has capabilities that rival that of Photoshop. Some of you may know that I created a tutorial similar to this one about a year ago, and you guys really seem to like it. So, I thought it was about time to create an updated version of the video in which I go a little bit more in depth, and hopefully my explanations can be a little bit more comprehensive. Alright, so first things first, we're gonna wanna go to Pixlr. So simply type in pixlr.com. Then, you're gonna wanna click on Pixlr E. Then, you should land on a page like this. First, you're going to want to click on Create New. And here, you can choose the dimensions of your logo. I'd suggest to simply go with something like 1000 by 1000. Just make sure that the width matches the height. Then, you can name your logo. It really doesn't matter what you put here. Make sure the background is turned off, and click on Create. Alright, so here we are in the image editor. So the kind of logo that I'm going to be creating in this video is what a lot of YouTubers use as their profile picture. Namely, we're going to be using a single letter as our profile picture. To do this, we're going to want to go to dafont.com. Here, you can choose from tons and tons of different fonts. They're completely for free, and I'm going to show you how to integrate them into Pixlr in a moment. Here on the top, you can choose a specific font category. I really like the look of this font right here, so I'm going to click on Download. Once it's downloaded, simply drag it onto your desktop, then right-click, and click on Extract here. And then all of these files should appear on your desktop. Simply go back to Pixlr, click on the Text tool, click in the center of your screen, and add a text layer. Then, simply type in the letter that you want for your channel. In most cases, you're probably just going to want to have the initials of your channel. As an example, I'm just going to use the letter A. Then, you're going to want to select it, and go up to Fonts. Then, you can click on Add Local Font, and then select your font that ends with TTF. As you can see, it appears on the top. Simply click on it, and there you go. Now this letter is obviously a bit too small, so I'm going to go to Size, and then increase it until I think it fits. Then, simply center it in the middle of your image. Make sure that your letter is not too big, as YouTube does cut off quite a bit of your logo when you upload it. Now, if you want to go with a more minimalist logo, you could simply keep it like this as a plain white color. However, if you want to use an image or a texture as an overlay to make it look a little bit more unique, I'm going to show you how to do that right now. First, simply think of any image or texture that you think would look good on your letter. For me, I'm just going to type in green texture. Go to images. And then simply select one that you like. I really like the look of this image right here, so I'm simply going to right-click it, and I'm going to save the image. Then, simply drag it into Pixlr. And of course, click on Add Current. Since the dimensions of my imported image are far greater than that of my file, I'm going to have to decrease the size of my image. So, simply select your image, go to Size, and then decrease it by however much you need. For me, I'm going to simply do 2000. Actually, I think 1000 looks much better than 2000, so I'm going to take my image and position it so that it covers the letter entirely. Then, I'm going to select the letter, go to the Magic Wand tool, select it, right-click it, click on Invert Selection, then select my image, go to Edit, and click on Cut. And now, as you can see, I've applied a texture to my letter. Now, as you can see, my letter still has a white outline, and to get rid of this, simply go to your original letter and uncheck the box. There. Now, you simply have the texture. One quick thing. If your image wasn't completely in frame when you were cutting it, then parts of it that weren't visible are still present. So you can simply drag them in, select your image, select the box selector, select your image, and click on Cut. There, now you simply have your letter. This may seem a little bit plain right now, but trust me, we're gonna make it look amazing. Now, we're gonna need a background. Simply go to Google and type in any background that you desire. Just make sure that it is not too detailed. For me, I think I'm gonna go with a galaxy background. I think I'm going to go with this one, as it's not too detailed, which is perfect for a background. Simply save the image. And then again, drag it, and click on Add Current. Perfect. Now like before, simply go to the size and decrease it by however much you need. Make sure your background is completely covering your logo, and then drag it below your letter. Now I'm going to select the background, click on Adjustment, and then click on Hue and Saturation. Since my letter has a nice and green texture, I'm going to change the hue of the background to something that complements the color a little bit more. Before you change anything, click on Colorize, and then adjust the hue, saturation, and lightness. I think this looks good, so I'm going to click on Apply. Next, I'm going to edit our letter. I'm going to go to Adjustment, and Hue and Saturation. I think that looks good, so I'm going to hit Apply. Now I'm going to add a drop shadow to the letter. Simply select it, go to Filter, and click on Drop Shadow. You can change the opacity of the drop shadow, and adjust the amount of blur it has. And I think this looks good, so I'm going to hit Apply. I think that the letter looks a little bit flat, so I'm going to select it, go to Filter, and go to Bevel. I'm going to adjust the size and the depth of the bevel as such. And once I like the settings, I'm going to hit Apply. Now the letter doesn't look as flat. I also think that the letter is a little bit dark still, so I'm going to go to Adjustment, and adjust the vibrance to be a little bit higher. One thing you can do to make your letter stand out a little bit more is go to Adjustment, click on Highlights and Shadows, and up the highlights slightly, and decrease the shadows slightly. And you can simply do this to your liking until it looks good. One thing we can do to the background to make it a little bit more interesting is go to Filter, and then give it a slight vignette. Now, at this point, we're pretty much done with our logo. However, I'm going to present you with a couple interesting effects that you can apply to your logo if you want to. One quite interesting effect that you can apply is by clicking on your letter, going to Filter, and then to Glitches, and on Interference. Then you can simply select if you want to be vertical or horizontal, and then increase or decrease the amount of interference. And with this, you can create a sort of glitch-type logo, as you can see. One interesting effect that you can apply to your background is by going to Filter, and then to Details, and then by clicking on Gaussian Blur. Simply adjust the amount, and you can basically blur the background to make the letter stand out that much more. I'm actually going to give my image a slight Gaussian blur. Awesome. Another interesting effect that you can apply to either your background or your letter is by going to Filter, Glitches, and by clicking on Scan Lines. And then you can get these cool old-style RGB scan lines. You can change the amount and the size right here. Another sort of glitch effect that you can apply is in the glitch section by clicking on fringe. Now, once you're happy with your logo, one last thing you can do by selecting your background, going to filter, and clicking on the effect library. Here, you can choose between several different categories, and you can basically change the style of your background. If you like any one of these, you can simply hit apply, and then you're good to go. Once you are completely done with your logo, you can go to File, Export, and click on Quick Export Image as PNG. And then, you have your very own logo you can use for your YouTube channel. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any further questions, simply leave them in the comment section. I'll do my best to answer as many as I can. If this tutorial helped you in any way, consider leaving a like. If not, feel free to smash that dislike button. But for now guys, stay safe, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye!